definitely a deal that you want to check out. It's called WP Compress. And if you skipped it in the past, you might want to check it out again because it's really improved from what it was from the beginning. So definitely stick around on this video to show you all the new settings that they have and how it's going to improve your WordPress page speed. So let's go check it out. WP Compress can do much more than just compressing images. It also has content delivery network, and it also functions as a cache plugin. Now, it's not as powerful as a cache plugin that's dedicated for that, but it does the trick. And if you don't want to mess around with a dedicated cache plugin, then this is a really great option. Now, like I said, advanced image compressing and resizing, cutting edge performance, kind of like a cache plugin. It has critical CSS, delay JavaScript, lazy load images, and a little bit more functions there. Content delivery network, which is a really great option. Now, be aware there's a lifetime deal going on right now, so check it out. Link will be provided in the description. Content delivery network is a system that's gonna load file nearest to them. What do I mean by that? Let's just say that your site is hosted on a Los Angeles server. So that means that if someone is watching it from France, from China, Australia, it's gonna go grab the files all the way from Los Angeles to wherever they're watching it. So it takes a little bit longer. It might be seconds or milliseconds. So those little milliseconds count when someone's watching your site. So that means that with content delivery network from WP Compress, it's gonna load files nearest to them. So if they have a server or a pop server in Frankfurt, Germany, and they're watching it from France, well, it's gonna load it from there and not from Los Angeles. So it's gonna be faster for them to deliver your images and files, okay? There's also a white label solution with this system. So let me jump over to my WP Compress dashboard. So right now I have connected 16 websites to this. Now, I don't use it for all my sites, but I do use it for some of them. Now, if I am looking for something that's really specific and really important for my site, I am using a dedicated content delivery network, a dedicated compressor, a dedicated cache plugin. But if I need it for a site where I have everything in one, this is a great option in my use case. It could be for you too. So like I said, check out the lifetime deal. Now, this is WP Compress on a WordPress site. I have the plugin installed and it's working, okay? Now, this is a site with low traffic, and right now it's saving me 19%, and this is the data served, original images saved, optimized, and assets served. So the images and files are served through WP Compress. So they are not causing server load on my hosting provider. So that's a really good thing, right? So if I don't have a really good hosting provider, this is gonna make my website perform better, okay? Now, let's go through the settings. When someone first installs WP Compress, you're gonna be greeted with this right here, aside from the API key, okay? Now, you have the option for safe mode, which is obviously a safe mode where it's not gonna do anything like this, but it's gonna use the compression and content delivery network. Now, if you wanna tweak even further, go with this or with aggressive mode, which adds all of these settings. Now, if your site works perfectly with aggressive mode, then you're good to go because you're gonna get the best performance. But this might break your site. It might kind of not load some things correctly, like some animations like that. So you need to enable it, test your site, and if it doesn't work as good, switch it to recommended mode or optimize it manually, okay? So I'm gonna leave it right now. I'm actually using custom mode. Because of that reason, because I don't want it to break some of the elements that I'm using, okay? Now, settings, CDN delivery. What type of files do you want content delivery network to load, okay? So basically, I want all of them to load to content delivery network because it's gonna be faster. And like I said, the example I give you, if someone is watching it in France and there's a server located nearest to them, a CDN on Frankfurt, on Spain, etc., it's gonna load from there. So images, SVGs, CSS, JavaScript, and fonts from over there, okay? There's also the custom CDN available if you want to use it. In this case, I did add it. So this site is Lifetime Deals CDN, which is the site that I have there, and I've added a CNAME to it. That means that it's gonna use my links when it loads the files. It's a really good option. Image optimization. These are the settings for the image optimization. So do you wanna resize by incoming device? So that means that if they're watching it on a phone, it's gonna load the image smaller. It's not gonna load the big image if you don't have something like this. So it's a pretty cool option. WebP images is really important for Google page speed. They want WebP images or else they won't give you a good score on it when you're testing it. Serve rendered images, obviously for Apple devices. Remove CSET. That's like some information that's in an image that's not really necessary, so you can remove it. Background images, lazy loading on these. I have it disabled for this particular site. I do have it enabled from other sites. So check this out. Optimization level. So it's gonna depend how much you want to compress it. If you have a website that's dedicated for images, if you're a photographer, obviously you don't want to compress it as much. So you have that option available there. And auto optimize on upload. So if you are uploading a new site, a new page or a new post, etc., when the image is uploaded, it's gonna optimize it once you upload it. So definitely a recommended setting, okay? Performance tweaks. This is where it comes into play, kind of like a cache plugin. Like I said, this is not a dedicated cache plugin, but they have the options available, which is pretty cool. So enable caching or not, exclude from caching. So let's just say that you have some elements that are not loading correctly. You can go ahead and fine tune it and add the URLs that you don't want to cache, so it doesn't break your site or it doesn't break a little element on it. Cache compatibility, expire cache after 6 hours. CSS optimization, you can minify critical CSS, combine CSS, inline combine. I mean, this is pretty cool having all of this in this plugin. JavaScript optimization. Then there's the other optimization settings. So you can disable emojis if you're not using it on your WordPress site. Disable dash icons, optimize external URLs, lazy load iframes, disable embeds, disable Gutenberg blocks. If you're not using that builder, then disable it. WooCommerce tweaks, minify HTML, and exclude specific ones. And then you have the UX settings. So these are for the user experience inside of WordPress. If you want to hide the admin bar, show the media library list, hide cache plugins. This is something I would use if you're using white label version of this. You want to kind of hide some things for this. Generate critical CSS. So it's generating for the homepage. So here it is, images, CSS, JavaScript, status, and run the action. So all that is included in this WP Compress plugin. If you ask me from what it was 1 year ago to what it is right now, it's made huge improvements in performance, in the user experience, and all the settings that they've been adding. So like I said, before it wasn't even like a kind of cache plugin, and now it kind of is, and they're adding more settings to this. So basically a recommended plugin if you want to optimize your WordPress site with something that's really easy to use. Now, once you fine tune it and you're ready to go, then you are gonna get good speeds on your website. But there you go. If you wanna grab the lifetime deal that's going on right now, check out the link in the description. And that's a wrap.